Okay, we used to call it methodology. So which is used for improving the business performance of the application. Okay, generally the purpose of the BPM is to improve the business performance of the application, and also in order to automate the work, means automation of work. Okay, here nothing is done manually. Actually in Pega everything is automated, means we will not configure anything manually or we will not do anything manually. Everything is available in the Pega BPM tool. Okay, everything is integrated in the tool itself. Okay, we are going to use the inbuilt resources. Okay, everything if you want. So what are the things required for developing an application? Everything is integrated in the Pega BPM tool itself. Okay, we are going to use those resources according to the requirement. Okay, all those features are inbuilt in this Pega BPM tool. Okay, see in the market, present market, we are having so many tools are available. See when we compare, so many tools like Lombard is a BPM, Oracle BPM is there, Epion, JBPM, ALBPM, like that so many BPM, small BPM tools are there. But when we compare Pega with other BPM tools, okay, Pega is the most advanced and there is no competition to the Pega BPM in the current market. Okay, those are all some simple small tools and we cannot compare them with the Pega BPM. Pega is the most advanced tool in the market and it is a Java based application actually. Pega is a Java based application and means the Java based application means don't worry, we will not use any Java coding or anything. In the backend, this total Pega tool is developed on Java. See, in the this total Pega tool is developed using Java language in J2E environment. But at the time of developing applications, see, mainly this Pega is used for developing web applications. We use this Pega BPM for developing any type of web applications. So all the new applications only, and also we can also monitor, see, and also we can do maintenance applications also, not only new applications, existing applications also we can do some modifications. Okay, Pega is a purely a development application, means we can develop any type of web applications using the Pega BPM. And at the time of development, Gopi, you can mute a microphone. Whenever you want to ask any question, you can unmute and you can ask me. Okay, there is a some mute option will be there. Okay, you can click on that option and whenever you have any queries you can ask. Okay, at the time of developing applications we will not write any coding here. Okay, without writing any coding we can develop applications, any type of web application, and majorly the domain, the type of domains will be like banking, healthcare. Banking is one of the major domain, healthcare, then marketing related applications, finance, insurance. So like this, any type of, not only these domains. So these are the major domains, like 70% of the market will be on these domains and the rest of the 30% on the remaining domains. Okay, like this, we can develop any type of application using the Pega BPM. And in the real time, I already told you Pega is a purely a Java based application. So Java based application means when they develop the Pega tool, this total Pega tool, in the backend it will automatically generate so many libraries. Means in Pega we used to call them as rules actually. In Pega terminology we used to call them as rules here. But in the, for example, in Java we used to call them as classes or libraries. In Java language we used to call them as classes or libraries, but in the Pega terminology the same classes or libraries we used to call them as rules here. Okay, automatically when they developed this Pega BPM tool, so in the backend we will have so many things, so many classes, so many libraries, so all the things are available, controls, functions, methods, everything is inbuilt in the Pega itself. And what happens means automatically at the time of developing an application, according to your requirement, you can select the required function or required control or required method or required class. So wherever required, you will be choosing the required option, and total design will be like everything is available. Just you have to use the drag and drop option or point and click option. Drag and drop or point and click. So like this, the total design of the application can be done without writing any coding. We will not write any single line of code. Without writing single line of code, we can develop the total web application. Okay, and one more thing is, it is also called as PRPC tool. In the real time, it is also called as PRPC tool. PRPC means Pegger Rules Process Commander. Already told you, rules are nothing but, Pegger rules are nothing but some classes or libraries, and process commander means some storage engine to store all the inbuilt rules in the Pegger BPM tool. Okay, in order to store all the inbuilt rules, process commander is a storage area. Okay, this total combinedly we used to call as Pegger PRPC tool. In the real time terminology, the Pegger is also called as Pegger PRPC BPM tool. Okay, this total, so we can call it as Pegger PRPC BPM. So anything is same, don't confuse. Like, so there are different domains, so like different modules here. So Pegger is contains only one thing, so that is Pegger BPM, or we can also call it as Pegger PRPC BPM. Okay, it is a product of Pegger systems. Pegger is a product of Pegger system. See, it doesn't have any other products. Okay, Pegger is the only product they have. And another thing is, it started in the year around 1984. Okay, it started as a middleware tool. And one more thing, by default, right now also, Pegger will have some middleware tool functionality. In the Pegger tool itself, by inbuilt, it has middleware functionality. Middleware means where we can convert one type of application into another format. For example, a Java application is there. We can convert into Pegger environment. Means it will, some middleware tool, it also acts as a, by inbuilt it also acts as a middleware tool. And later they have started some modifications in that, and they have started as a, designed as a development tool. Around in the 1990s, they started with 1x version, and later on some 2x, 3x, 4x, and in the 2004 or 2005 they released some 5x version, and currently they are using 6.3 and 7.1 versions. 6.3 and 7.1. 7.1 still they are not using in all the companies. Okay, right now mainly 70% or 80% of the market is on 6.3, and 10% of the market is on 6.2 version, and Pegger Systems is only using the 7.1 version. It will take some time to implement in the companies right now. Okay, the training will be on 6.3, and some features it also covers 7.1 also. Okay, so what are the new features covered in 7.1 and also in 6.3 also, we'll have some training. Okay, and this is about the versions. And when I compare this Pegger with other languages in the market, for example, in the BPM market, we don't have any competition to the Pegger BPM. If you compare with the BPM market, we don't have any competition here. Okay, Pegger is the one of the largest tool. Okay, and there is no other competition in the BPM category. In when we compare with other languages, so we can, a stiff competition for the Pegger tool is Java, because what are the things we can do in Java, everything we can also do in Pegger, and we can do more also. So what are the things you are doing in Java language, same things we can also do in Pegger also. For example, take Java. If you are developing one banking application, same thing we are also developing in Pegger also. Okay, when we compare the pros and cons of these two things, Java and Pegger. For example, in Java, if you want to develop an application, we used to develop using object-oriented libraries. Using the libraries, we used to develop applications. And in Pega, the terminology will be different, but the same thing. We used to call us here object-oriented rules, we used to call in Pega language. Or actually Pega is not a language, it is a tool, and Java is a language. And in Java, if you want to develop any application or if you want to design the forms, there is no, it will not follow any model. Means each and everyone will follow their own pattern for developing an application. So there is no structure or anything for developing an application in Java language. But in Pega, they used to follow some model, and anyone in the application will follow the same process. Okay, anyone in the application, even if some developer 1, developer 2, anyone will follow the same process in if they use the Pega language, Pega tool. Okay, that is the another difference. And another thing is the development time is, so when we compare the development time in Java, if a same application, if it is taking 2 years time, the same thing we can complete in Java, in Pega we can complete within 1 year. In Pega we can complete within 1 year. Okay, here the development time is very less, and also the production cost is very less. Okay, and also the so many advantages of that. So these two are main advantages: the development time very less, and also production cost very less. The number of errors at the time of designing application, and at the same time, not only this, so the redundancy in the application, so like maintenance costs. So when we compare with the Java, so there are so many advantages in the Pega tool, Pega BPM tool. Okay, so overall production wise and the cost wise, it will save so much for the organizations and both the clients also. So it is advantageous for both the clients and the organizations. Okay, that is the reason. So many companies now, all the projects are billing on Pega only. So even in US, India, so anywhere, so most of the projects presently, all the Java projects are moving into the Pega language. And another difference is, if you want to configure, suppose in Java means we need to manually configure the database. We need to manually configure the database. But in Pega, the database is setup is created automatically. The database setup is created automatically. And another difference is the maintenance costs are very low in Pega. Why? Because in most of the companies, what they will do is, so the main project, the new application will be developed in Java, and the maintenance application will be done in Pega, because it will save around 50% of the maintenance cost. And some other advantage also that when we compare the security wise or at the same time performance wise, okay, Pega is better than the Java language. So these are all some of the main minimum, so our major benefits or major advantages over the Java language. Okay, anything we can do using Pega with more advantage. Okay, that is the reason. So all the clients are moving to the Pega technology. And some of the features I want to discuss. So main features in Pega is, okay, before that I want to tell you one thing. See, Pega, whenever we install the Pega software, along with Pega, automatically it will install some things. Like in the backend, it will install Java. Why? Because it is a, because Pega tool is developed using Java. That is the reason. In the backend, it will install Java, and also one database, and one application server. Okay, whenever we install the Pega software, these three comes as a package: Java, database, and server. And Pega contains two types of editions: personal edition and enterprise edition. Yeah, personal edition and enterprise edition. But what is the difference between these two editions is, in the real-time applications, in the companies we will use, yeah, Kiran, mute your microphone. If you want, if you have any queries, you can ask me. Okay, personal edition and enterprise edition. Enterprise edition is used in the real-time applications, and personal edition, see, whenever you want to practice or if you want to install in your system, you will get the personal edition. See, the options and everything is same when we compare with the enterprise edition. So the only difference between these two editions is somebody getting a noise from your side. Kiran or Gopi, mute your microphones.
Yeah, I muted.
Okay, Kiran, please mute your microphone. Just to click on the mute option, you can hear my audio. If you want to ask any question, you can unmute your option. Yeah, Kiran, can you hear me, Kiran? Okay, yes. Okay, so personal edition and enterprise edition, the options are same. So when we open the tool, so all the options will be same, but only the difference is in the personal edition, we'll have limited database and server. We'll have limited database and server. That is the only difference. Okay, rest of the things, what are the options we get in enterprise edition? Same options we'll get in personal edition also. Here also we can develop on full-fledged application. Okay, only difference is we'll get a limited database and server. Rest of the thing, so all the options are same as enterprise edition. Okay, enterprise edition actually it will cost around so like lakhs of crores of rupees. Okay, but personal edition is a free edition and it is also a full version, means not like a trial version, it is also full edition, not like a trial edition. Once if you install the personal edition, it will work lifetime. Okay, and in the personal edition, we'll be getting a default database and server. Okay, at the same time, limited database and server, at the same time, there will be default database and default server we'll get. For example, if I take 6.3 edition, it will install Java, then coming to the database, PGSQL database, and server is Tomcat. But if you, in the enterprise edition, according to the application requirement, they can install any database and any server. Pega supports all databases and servers. If you are working on enterprise edition, you can install any database according to the application requirement. It supports all databases like Oracle, SQL Server, Sybase, Universal Database, okay, MySQL, any database it supports. And coming to the servers, it also supports all servers, like majorly they will use Tomcat, WebLogic, WebSphere. According to the requirement, they can select the application server. It also supports all the servers, whatever available. Okay, this is in the personal edition, but we'll get by default, we'll get the default database and default server. Here we'll not get an option to choose the database and server. By default, along with the version, we'll get some database and server. Compulsory, we have to go with that. But don't worry, in Pega, if you want to learn this Pega, no need to have any prerequisites. See, no need to have any knowledge on anything. No need to have any database knowledge. No need to have any Java knowledge. Okay, no need to have any basic knowledge also. Without any basic knowledge, you can learn the Pega BPM. Why? Because, see, we will not write any, see, what are the database you use? Even if you use Oracle or Sybase, any database you take, so the process will be same. Because see, in Pega, we will not write any queries. We will not write any queries. But how to perform the logical insert or fetch or delete or anything. For that, we are having some methods are there. Pega contains some predefined methods. Okay, any operations, any configurations we have to do, we will be doing using the methods only. So Pega contains around 120 to 130 methods are there. If you want to do any logical operation, we will be doing using the available methods. Okay, that is the reason any database key, by default we are using PGSQL, right? Even if you use Oracle or any other database also, the process will be same. At the time of table creation, okay, we'll create a normal table. See, and one more thing is the database is internal in the Pega tool itself. Means Normally, if you install any other language, we have to externally configure the database. But here, in the Pegard tool itself, we'll have the database. Means all the database connections and mapping will be done in the Pegard tool itself. After logging to the Pegard tool, inside the Pegard tool only we'll have the database. Okay, no need to worry about any. If even if you don't have any database knowledge also, no need to worry, because we will not write queries here. Okay, any database use, the process will be same. Without any writing any queries, we can map all the connections. Means inserting, if you want to do insert to the database, if you want to fetch from the database, okay, delete from the database, okay, any mapping if you want to perform, we will be doing using the predefined methods. Okay, this is about the, and if you want to install this Pega software with minimum system requirements, anyone can install the software. I will be sharing the software with you. You can download that one and you can install in your systems. So that installation, how to set up and all, I will, in the regular sessions I will tell you. And just minimum system requirements are for installing the Pega software. Just you can install in either Windows 7 or Windows 8, 64-bit operating system, not 32-bit. 32-bit it will not install. Windows 7 or Windows 8 or 8.1 version. Okay, 64-bit operating system, and RAM size minimum 2 GB RAM, and in the C drive you must have a space around at least 10 GB free space must be there. Okay, these are the basic requirements. Anyone can install the Pega software. Okay, that one we'll do in the regular sessions. And coming to the one of the main features of the Pega BPM, it's, see, once we install the Pega software, everything will be done internal in the Pega tool itself. No need to install any other software separate from the Pega tool. Okay, once Pega software is installed, everything will be done in the Pega itself. Means inside the Pega tool itself, no need to install any other tools from apart from this Pega BPM tool. For example, see, once we start the application, so from designing, then development, administration, security, testing, all these things will be done in the same tool itself. No need to install any other tool. So from designing to testing, everything will be done in the Pega tool itself. Means it provides end-to-end solutions. Pega provides end-to-end solutions. Okay, and that is one of the main feature in Pega. Okay, within the Pega tool itself, we'll do the designing, development, administration, security and testing. Means Pega contains different roles will be there. See, inside the Pega, there are different types of roles, like developer is one role. We used to call them as system architect. In Pega, we used to call them as system architect. Then business analyst. We used to call as business analyst. Then manager. Then administrator. Okay, these are all the four different types of roles we'll be having. Okay, based on the role in the organization, we have to perform the, suppose system architect means developers. Developers will have a separate portal for designing. Business analyst will have their separate portal for doing analysis, so creating the profile setups. So everything will be done by the work assignments. Everything will be done by the business analyst. The work manager portal. Manager will have a work manager portal. He will be monitoring the total application. And administrator. Actually, in Pega, there will not be separate administration team. Either these two, either business analyst or manager or some senior developer will act as a administrator. There will not be a separate administration. So only within the organization or within the that particular project, who can manage the things. So they will, suppose mainly business analyst or manager will act as a administrator. Okay, there will not be a separate team for that. Okay, like this, so different types of roles will be there. Okay, these are one of the main feature, and it supports means like all databases and servers. So what are the databases available and what are the servers available in the market, Pega supports all databases and servers, and also it is provides version capability. Pega provides version capability means an application, so an application which is developed in lower version, it also works in higher version. Okay, application can work in any version, and also it is the best tool to build. Web services. So in Pega BPM tool, if we want to connect to any type of integration services or integration connectors, so all the connectors and services are inbuilt in the Pega tool itself. In other cases, in other languages, we need to manually configure them. Means there the process will be somewhat difficult when we compare with the Pega. Actually in the Pega tool itself, everything is designed, like all the connectors and all the services are available. So just we have to provide the particular URL or particular path, and automatically it will create a setup. Okay, the process is very easy here. Okay, when we compare with other languages, the web services part is very easy here. That is one of the main feature here. And also the database connections, similar to the web services, the database connections is also very advanced and very easy here. Okay, the task is very easy when we compare with other languages. Okay, like this. At the same time, user interface also means for designing the forms. So here for designing the forms means we used to call it as user interface. The user interface is so very advanced here. Means if you want to design an user interface, suppose if you want to write a coding and everything, when it takes some 1000 lines of code, and if it is taking some 2 or 5 days or 1 week time, same thing we can complete within, like we can complete in 1 day. So a task which is taking some 1 week time in Java language, that same task we can complete in 1 day in Pega here. Okay, that is the so difference. Can you give me a minute? I'm getting one call. I need to attend that one. So just a minute, I'll be back.
Hello?
Okay, sorry guys, just a call. Okay, these are all the features of the Pega BPM tool. Okay, these are some of the main features in Pega. And coming to the what are the things, Pega contains so many rules will be there. See, if you want to develop an application, means Pega contains, see in Pega one more thing, everything is called as a rule here. Rule means using the predefined rules, we are going to develop our own user defined rules. So means in Pega, whatever we are going to develop, everything is called as a rule here. Means for example, simply saying, if you are creating one simple properties, you are going to create some properties, right? So even we used to call as property rule. If you are developing some condition, we used to call as a decision rule. Means the terminology will be different here. But in Pega, everything is called as a rule here. Means like a property rule, condition rule, user interface rule, workflow rule. Okay, in Pega, the terminology will be called as a rule here. Everything is called as a rule. Like this, we can develop any number of rules according to the requirement. Means for each and everything, so there will be some category will be there. Means different categories like data model category, user interface is one category. Means under the data model, we'll create all the data tables and properties. Under the user interface, the total form designing will be done. And there is one more called process category. Under this, we'll be designing all the workflows, then validations, some notifications, service levels. So, okay, so many things will be there. Then there is one thing called technical category. Under this, we'll write all the logical things. Means all the methods will be there. Okay, all the predefined methods will be there. All the logical parameters. Okay, any parameters, if you want to map any data. Okay, inserting, fetching, deleting. So all the things will be done under the technical category. And then we'll have decision. So there is one thing called decision. Under this category, we'll add different types of conditions will be there. Okay. For your properties or for your forms, if you want to add any conditions, all the conditions will be defined under the decision category, like decision tables, decision trees, mapping the values, when conditions, if conditions, else if conditions. Okay, all types of conditions will be defined under the decision category. And there is one more thing called declare. So declarative rules. Under the declarative functions, we'll define the expressions. On change means this is also related to the decision only, but in a different format. Here also we will add some different types of conditions will be there. Like this, then integrations will be there. Okay, under the integrations we'll have integration services, connectors, mapping, resources. Okay, then reports generating, testing. Okay, testing tools will be there inbuilt only. Like this, everything is available in the Pega only. According to the workflow, we have to design all these things. And if you want to start an application means, okay, if you want to start an application means, so there are two things we need to do before starting an application, like which to call as, we need to create some workspace here. And we need to create a setup, organization setup. Okay, so like this, so many things will be there. So we'll be doing all these things. And coming to the tool, if you want to check the tool means, already told you at the, if we along with the Pega, in the backend it will install Java, one database and one server, application server. Okay, automatically if you want to log into the Pega tool means we'll be working on the internet actually. Means the server will be located in the your system only. Okay, no need to connect to any external server. No need to connect to any external server. The server will be located in your personal system only. Okay, means the server will be intranet server. Okay, no need to connect to any cloud or any external server. We will be working on the intranet server. Means whenever you want to log into the Pega tool, you need to start the intranet. Means here the server name is Tomcat. The application server is Tomcat. Okay, once after starting the server, actually there is icons, right? startup icon, shutdown icon, login icon. If you want to start the server, click on this startup icon. Means already the server is started in my system. You just need to click on the login icon. Okay, this is a login page, and you will be having some default user ID and password. Whenever you are, suppose you are a new user, if you want to log into the Pega BPM tool, it contains some default user ID. That is administrator@pega.com. Password install. Okay, this is one of the default user ID. Okay, from the administrator ID, whenever you want to start a new application, we have to create some setup actually. Okay, after creating the setup, again we need to create some workspace. Under the workspace, we have to create our, and we have to start our own application designing. Okay, that one we'll do in the coming regular sessions. Okay, once if you log into the tool, see everything will be done in the Pega tool itself. No need to go outside. All the options and all the things are integrated in the tool itself. Okay, this is a sample home page. Okay, and this is a sample application actually. Okay, by default we'll get some sample thing like Pega sample. So these are all the categories I told you, right? And this is Pega sample. This is a main class. Under this, again we are having some subclasses are available. Means, for example, if you take one application, if you will be working on multiple modules, right? Like that, if an application can contain multiple modules. So like that, whenever you are working on a different module, you will create a separate subclass. Under that, again you will be creating all the rules. Okay, these are all the different categories: data model, process, decision, user interface, integrations, reports, technical, security, organization, sysadmin, okay, application definition. Okay, like so many things will be there. Okay, all these things will be done by us only. So we have to develop all these things under the data model. So properties, creations, validations, all those things will be there. Under the process, the workflows, creation, correspondence, service levels, validations, work parties. Under the decision, we'll have different types of conditions. All are conditions only. According to our requirement, we have to select the each and type format. Under the user interface, the total designing, means designing of your web pages will be done under the user interface using all these rules. And integration, connectors, mapping, services, all those things comes under integration. So see here, all the types of connectors are inbuilt here. Okay, these are all the inbuilt connectors. So just we have to provide the inputs and we need to configure the web services. Then under the reports category, we can generate the reports in the Pega tool itself. So any type of report we can generate. Under the technical category, we will have an activity important rule where we can generate all the logical things and everything. Security means, so providing security for accessing the different types of roles, giving permissions to the whoever working in the application. Means this is related to the developer environment. Means within the application, who can access, what are the things they can access, those things will be given under the security tab. Organization contains all the user IDs. Okay, so the total setup IDs and everything will be there under the organization. Sysadmin, if you want to create a classes and everything, or different types of database connections, so all those things will be created under the from the sysadmin like this. So these are all the different types of roles. See, it will be look, whenever you create a, you start a new application, similarly you also have to create all these things. Okay, you also need to create all these things according to the requirement for the application. Okay, whenever you start, when you start an application, you will not get all these things. We have to create all these things by ourselves according to the requirement. Okay, you can ask me any doubts from your side. Any questions you want to ask, you can ask me now. Okay, this is a basic introduction about the Pega BPM. And from my side, okay, you'll be, so the training will be around 30 to 35 days. Okay, you'll be getting all the software materials and dumps. So with my certification, you can keep around 3 to 5 years of experience on Pega. Okay, you can easily crack the interviews. And any certification help, and at the same time, resume preparations. Okay, all the help from me, you'll get from me. If you want to ask any questions, you can ask me.
Hey, nothing, no questions, like, you know, just let me know at what time the classes will be in the next.
From the next Thursday, I will be starting the sessions from 6:30 a.m. IST.
Okay. From next Thursday?
Yes.
Okay.
I will inform the organizer. He will contact you. So okay. Whether Wednesday or Thursday.
Yeah. Sure.
Yes, Kiran, any queries, Kiran?